Hey guys, Philly Diva coming to you, and this video I've been wanting to make for such a long time, and I'm finally making it. So it's here. My summer hair is here, you guys. I know I've been talking about this forever. It's here. Oh, whew, don't damage it. So the hair is here, you guys. I got it this week. I actually decided to go with Virgin Indian natural curly hair. Let me tell you guys a little bit about virgin hair in case you don't know. I do have I have used in the past Remy hair, Remy Indian hair, which is totally different from virgin Indian hair. Remy hair is pretty much it's pretty good, but typically Remy hair is processed. Virgin Indian hair is unprocessed completely. There's no manipulation to its texture or its color. So this is straight up virgin pure hair, like me. So this is what the hair looks like, you guys, in the packaging. On the packaging, it comes with some instructions, and this is what I'm going to go through with you guys today, because I have to do a few steps prior to me installing it. Plus, I'm not going to install it until the week before my graduation, which is probably, well, my graduation is May 16th, so I'll install it the week before. But I want to prep the hair. According to the website, by the way, I got the hair from jujuhair.com. This company, you guys, I'm telling you, first of all, the website is so cool. It's so user-friendly. It was so easy to navigate through the website. I found exactly what I wanted instantly. Of course, you know me, I had questions, so I called them, and oh my God. Like, the customer service at Juju Hair, you guys, is like 5 thumbs up. I'm telling you. Like, they are so freaking nice and friendly at Juju Hair, and I called them, I didn't get like a voicemail. I got someone live on the phone. I spoke with them. They were courteous. They were kind. They were informative, and trust me, I've dealt with some really messed up customer service. Juju Hair is like the complete opposite. They were so pleasant on the phone. So anyway, on the packaging, it says, congratulations on your new hair. Yay! So they ask you, well, they recommend that you do some transformation steps prior to installing the hair. And I think that is so important when you're installing any hair. Sometimes when we get weaves or extensions, we don't do anything to the hair prior to putting it in. We just get it out the pack and bam, put it in our hair. Not even knowing, like, you know, where the hair was from, you know, what kind of chemicals on it. So this is a really important step that the company is recommending. So of course I'm going to follow the steps, and I would have did this even if it was not recommended. So what they say to do in regards to the transformation steps is, step 1, cold wash the hair with a moisturizing shampoo. They didn't say any specific kind of moisturizing shampoo, I mean not shampoo, conditioner, but I'm going to probably use something like Herbal Essence or something like that. So that's step 1, cold wash the hair with a moisturizing conditioner. Step 2 is rinse the hair thoroughly with cold water. Step 3 is allow the hair air dry. And then step 4, you can install it. But before I get to my step 4, I'm actually going to put a rinse on the hair. Now, like I said initially, this is virgin Indian hair. Look how gorgeous that is, you guys. Look how gorgeous. And this is not even, like, I haven't even transformed it yet. Look how gorgeous it is already. Now, this is the 14 inches. I got 14 inches and I got 18 inches. And upon my request, I wanted the darkest color, which is typically like a 1B for virgin natural hair. So this is the 18 inches and this is the 14 inches. As you can see, there is a slight color discoloration of the two. Well, maybe you can't see, but I definitely can see. The 14 inches is more like a number, I say a number 2, which is gorgeous also, but I typically wear my hair in a number 1B, sometimes a number 1, and that's what the 14 inches is. But what I'm going to do with both of them, after I do my transformation steps, I'm going to put a rinse on both of them. And like I said initially, with virgin Indian hair, this is as pure as it gets. There's no color on this. There's no chemicals in it to make it curly like this. This is how a lot of Indians' natural hair is, and this is how it comes in the bundle. It's actually a lot of hair if you look at the bundle. And mama is going to use all of this. Yes, big hair. Love it. So I'm going to take you guys through the co-washing steps. And then next week, I'll probably do the rinse. So I'll bring that video to you, showing you how I color the hair. I'm not going to put a permanent color on it because I don't want it to be permanent. I'm just going to put a little rinse on it to make the colors very, very similar to each other. I mean, I could probably wear this like this because it's a natural color, but I'm gonna make them more of a 1B number one color. So let's do the co-wash. So I'm actually now in my kitchen. Wow, you never seen this part of my house, but I'm in my kitchen because I want to use my my sink hose. It's easier to use that. And I'm also going to use a little pail. And I actually decided to use the Suave Humectant conditioner. It looks like this. I really like this conditioner a lot because it is really, really moisturizing. I use this a lot on my daughter's hair, who has like super really thick hair and dry hair, and it really conditions her hair really well. And this is kind of compared to Nexxus, but it's like half the price, seriously. So what I'm going to do now is just fill my pail up with some lukewarm water, and I'm going to put a little bit of the conditioner in the water also. So now I have my hair in the pail of water with the conditioner in it. I'm going to keep the hair bundled up, you guys. I'm not going to undo the bundles until I am ready to dry it. So I'm going to do one at a time. So I'm going to take the hair like so, and I'm going to submerge it into the water. Like so. All the way into the water. Okay. Now the conditioner is in the water already. So it's getting onto the hair. And what you kind of can do is kind of just take, you know, do like a finger comb through it. Oh, mama, this is so freaking lovely. Are y'all seeing this? I'm going to take a little bit more conditioner because I want this baby to be moisturized. And go through it really thoroughly like so. Let's put a little bit onto the ends. That was a lot, but it's all right. Just like natural hair, focus on those ends. Are you guys seeing that? See how the texture is really defined now? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to rinse it with cold water. Remember, I washed it with lukewarm. I'm going to rinse it with cold water. You can probably repeat the process like you would do with your natural hair, but I don't think it's necessary because this hair is super, super soft right now. So I'm going to repeat the steps with the other pack, and then I'll be back, you guys. Okay, I'm back to my studio, and I'm actually towel drying the hair with a t-shirt. I'm not taking no chances with this hair. No towels on this. So the way I'm drying it, you guys, I'm just squeezing the excess water out like so. Okay. Same way you would do your natural hair. Now what I'm going to do is actually open the bundles so they can air dry. This is what it looks like wet. Okay. So I'm going to open the bundles up by just cutting the string that's holding it together, not cutting the tracks, and I'm just gonna just open it up a little bit so it can air dry a whole lot faster like that. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hang my hair onto a hanger so it can air dry, and I'm just gonna use some clips to hold it in place. Hold the tracks in place. Like so. You see the clips? The things we do for hair. So you guys, that is how you do the co-wash on the virgin Indian hair. You want to do this process to just to get the hair at a really soft state. It already comes soft, but the cold wash makes it a whole lot softer from root, from top of the track all the way down to the edge. As you can see, the texture is forming. And it is simply gorgeous. So I'll let this air dry and then I will come to you guys with another video showing you how I do the rinse.